Good morning, Dr. Prasad. This is Radha Krishnan. I have been following your predictions very closely. Everybody is interested in the news. Yeah, news stands for North, East, West, South. Doctor, you have covered the elections in Tamil Nadu, south of India. So we are very keen to know from you, what is going to happen in the eastern side? Yes, I mean, at West Bengal, where the toughest fight is happening between BJP and Mamata. We are very keen to know who will take over West Bengal. Over to you, Doctor.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Radha Krishnan, and good morning to you. And good morning and good evening to all the viewers. Yeah, it is a very interesting question, right? I mean, a lot of, heated battle is going on in West Bengal, you know, both yes. these two parties and the other third party, it's nowhere in the picture, which is Congress and CPI. It's very unfortunate. CPM ruled for so many years in the state, and currently yes. it's nowhere in the picture as a main opposition. Okay, so coming back to the predictions, right? If I have to look at the predictions, I need who's running, main person, right? So for Ms. Mamata Banerjee, it is very clear from Trinamool Congress, she is the leader and she is the chief ministerial candidate. There is no doubt in that. But when it comes to BJP, there is nobody, right? Okay. So they are putting, Modi. Is Modi going to be a CM candidate? Then it's different. Then I can say it. I can take Modi's horoscope and then Mamata Banerjee's horoscope and then compare who has the better chances of winning, right? Or Amit Shah or Mr. Nadda or anybody else. So there is no strong leader. It's very hard to predict, to take that side who can win, right? So then I took a Prashna Jyotish approach. All right. And then I analyzed Mamata Banerjee's horoscope, whatever the details I could get from internet. So based on that, this election is going to be even much more closer, tough fight for Mamata Banerjee. It is not going to be easy. It is going to be very, very tough. Okay. I would say even if at all she wins, like it will be like in a thin margin like that. It is very tough fight, but one good thing or whatever, now from astrological point of view, I'm saying it's not that don't take it. Astrologically, what happened? If you have seen her, she has injured her leg.
Okay.
Her leg got injury, right? So she is campaigning in the wheelchair. But there is a controversy behind, it is she is faking and all, but leaving aside.
Okay.
Right?
Find out.
Leaving aside. I'm not going there. But for all the election campaigning, she is only going in the wheelchair. Oh, wheelchair, right? That is what she is doing. She is not walking, she is struggling. Astrologically, she is running Saturn Mahadasha. Saturn Mahadasha is like a little problematic to her. Okay. So every planet will give both positive and negative during the, during its period.
Okay.
So because of that, her injury, because it's a leg injury means thumb rules very straight. Saturn is the only reason. Saturn is the only planet can cause leg injuries. That too, especially below ankle. Around that area only, I think. I don't know.
Okay.
So leg means it's bottom part of the body means it is Saturn only. So that way, she is undergoing the Saturn negative karma in the form of campaigning in wheelchair.
Okay.
So this is, so she is releasing the karma. So this is going to help her in winning.
Oh.
because of that wheelchair, she's campaigning in the wheelchair. Okay, that is going to help her gaining few more seats because she's releasing the Saturn karma. If she is
fulfilling,
she has not done that, or that injury didn't happen, or whatever, then there's a good chance that she may lose. But since she is doing this, so okay, my calculation or my intuition, it's leaning towards little bit towards her because she may have edge in the end because of that injury. Okay, so she is doing it. Maybe people may feel more sympathy towards her, and then people also might comment and vote. But that and all thing, but as far as astrology is concerned, she is releasing the Saturn karma, and then which is going to help her to release it.
Great, great. So we all know that somehow we have to follow the karma, we have to do whatever the karma comes to us. You have told many times, so you cannot escape from the karma. Now, knowingly or unknowingly, Mamta is doing it. So we all wait with our fingers crossed for the result to come. But as you said, it's going to be very tough. That means Vijay is going to gain some more prominence in that state.
Yeah.
So we will all wait for that. Thank you for sharing your predictions on what is going to happen on the year.
Thanks for watching my video. If you need astrology or vastu consultations, please contact me at 408-909-5867 or visit at my website www.astrologyfouryou.us.